convinced in that process that homosexuality was not and never has been abnormal. It's minority. There's a difference. You can be a minority without being abnormal. Left-handed people are a minority. They're not abnormal. Red-headed people are a minority. They're not abnormal. Sexual orientation is a given, not a chosen. That's another insult. It never occurred to me that I had not chosen to be heterosexual. I just woke up when I was 12 or 13 and suddenly girls did not seem obnoxious to me. I made no decision about that. I just began to do strange things like use deodorant, take baths. Which I had not been pleased to do up until that time. My mother, noting this strange behavior in her adolescent son, said, "The sap has risen." I didn't know what that meant either. I told how this personal journey had carried me in a very different direction. I learned how homosexuality was present in the animal kingdom. I learned that homosexuality has been present in every human society, in every age of humanity since the dawn of time, in about the same percentages. It is so hard to assume that that could happen because people cause people to become homosexual. I learned that no one can make another person homosexual. And I learned that no homosexual can ever be cured. Cure is something you do for a disease. This was not a disease. This was a normal part of the human spectrum of sexual behavior. And I concluded that quoting the Bible in order to condemn homosexuality is simply not relevant to the debate. I talked about the gay people I'd known. I suggested that every bishop there, if he were open, would recognize that they had gay or lesbian people in their extended families. They certainly had them in their dioceses and in their congregations, even in their most born-again fundamentalist congregations. Legislation is pending at this moment in New York, in New Hampshire, in New Jersey. In New Jersey, where our outstanding governor, John Corzine, has promised to sign the marriage equality bill if the legislature will only pass it. Today, gay clergy are so commonplace we don't even pay them any attention. They're recognized everywhere. The record of progress is clear. Once a cultural prejudice is publicly debated, it is already dying. That's just a fact. Just a matter of time. You don't debate a prejudice publicly until the presuppositions that have been upholding that prejudice are so eroded that they will never hold the prejudice up. The opponents of equal rights are declining. Oh, they're still loud, but they're declining. They've lost the battle. The victory needs to be claimed. Indeed, in the past 20 years, the world has moved on so dramatically. Recognizing civil unions is now the conservative fallback position. That's just a fact. Don't ask, don't tell is on its way out in the military. I expect it to be gone before this year is over. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton, by the signature of her pen, just this past week authorized full benefits for the partners of gay and lesbian diplomats. A generation ago, to be a gay or lesbian diplomat was to be immediately fired because you were thought to be subject to blackmail. When asked why Secretary Clinton took this action, she responded, "Because it is right." My point is that your work has been instrumental in bringing about the new consciousness that is sweeping the world. And the victory is at hand. I think the time for debate is over. I don't want to debate this subject with anybody at any point. I don't want to dispute it. I'll listen, but I'm not going to engage you. I don't engage members of the Flat Earth Society either. There comes a time when a consensus is formed, and you don't have to keep on debating it. It's time rather to claim the victory. It's time to assume the victory. It's time to act on the victory. As Eric Fromm once observed, people do not think their way into new ways of acting. They always act their way into new ways of thinking. So my brothers and sisters, I commend you. I commend you for your life and for your witness. I commend you for making the Christian faith real in the lives of people who had given up hope that Christ would ever speak to them. I commend you for being who you are. So claim the victory. Walk into the future and be not afraid. You have accomplished great things in the 20 years of your life. So rejoice in them. Be glad about them. And claim them with pride.